Hello students, and welcome to the channel as we are providing you the solutions of those aptitude questions of TCS mock test. So here I'm presenting you another bunch of questions. So here we go. So here's the first question. Isha, Babu and Chitra work in a handicraft factory. Isha alone takes 10 hours to complete a single product, but Babu and Chitra working together take 4 hours for completion of the same single product. If all of them worked together and completed 14 products, then how many hours have they worked? 54, 40, 28 or 30 hours? So let's have the solution. Isha alone is taking 10 hours to complete a single project, single product, and Babu and Chitra take 4 hours to complete the same product. So we'll follow our routine part. Isha, that means 10 hours, and Babu plus Chitra 4 hours. If I'll take the LCM 10 and 4, it would be 20. That means 2 units of work done by Isha in 1 hour and 5 units of work are done by B and C in 1 hour. And this is the total work done. What is the total work they are doing? They are making a single product. That means in a single product, how many units of work are required? 20, isn't it? Then what about 14 single products if I'll need? That means I have to do 280 units of work. Isn't it? Very simple. And we know that in 1 hour, Isha is doing 2 units. B and C, that is Babu and Chitra, are doing 5 units. What is Isha, Babu and Chitra's combined efficiency? 5 plus 2. They are doing 7 units in just 1 hour. I have to want 280 units. The total number of hours would be, simple a division of them, 280 is 2, 7, 40. 40 hours they have to work to get 14 products ready if all of the 3 work together. So moving to the next question. A grocer stacks oranges in a pyramid-like stack whose rectangular base is 5 oranges by 8 oranges. That means like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And similarly following the same route. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These two are not there. Okay, he is following continuous the same route. Okay, then each orange above the first level rests in the pocket formed by the 4 oranges, like here. Now again orange is placed over here, second would be here, next would be here, next would be here. Similarly follow the same route. Pockets formed by the 4 oranges. Now this time, moving to the case question now, the stack is completed by a single row. It is forming a pyramid, one stack, another upper stack, and finally a just single row of oranges. How many oranges are in the stack? Initially, there were how many oranges? The first very stack, 8 is to 5, that means 40 oranges would be there. Okay. In upper level, in another level, when we are placing them in pockets, we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, that means 7 into 4, that is 28. Similarly, if I have to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now I have to place between these pockets 1, 2 and 3. Similarly along this side, again in this side it would be 6 now and it would be 3. 6 is to 3, 18 oranges. In another level it would be 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2. That means 5 is to 2. And another is a just a single line, 4 is to 1, that means 4. When you sum them up, it would be 100 oranges. Just a clear case of visual. You just have to arrange up in according to a just a logic and you will be having your answer. First of all, 8 is to 5, then another upper level stack is coming, which is having one lesser than other. Next, another 1 minus 1, next another minus 1 on the both sides. So here we have developed the logic. Okay, moving to the next question, and here is your answer, option C. The average of 5 consecutive, that means which are coming continuously, integers starting with M as the first integer is N. What is the average of 9 consecutive integers that start with M plus 2? What is given to us? We have given with the 5 average of 5 consecutive numbers, and that average 2 is n, and the numbers are starting with n. So I can write it, n could be equal to 1 over 5 m plus 1 m plus 2 m plus 3 plus m plus 4. It is given to me. And what I was supposed to calculate, first I'll calculate this one, what is n and m's relation between them, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 m, and 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, that is 10. So I can have n equals to m plus 2. Okay. This is a condition I have derived. What we have to calculate, we have to calculate the average of 9 consecutive numbers. So I'm dividing it by 9, and consecutive numbers are starting from m plus 2, m plus 2, m plus 3, m plus 4, m plus 5, m plus 6, m plus 7, m plus 8, m plus 9, m plus 10. Okay, when I'll solve this further, 1 over 9 is equal to 9m plus 2 plus 3 up to 10. When you further solve this expression, I'll be having 9m plus 54, and solve this further, it would be m plus 6. We are not having any one of them, but we are having a relation between them. Instead of m plus 6, can I write like this, m plus 2 plus 4? What is m plus 2? N? N plus 4? And here is the answer, n plus 4. Moving to the next question. In a class, 120 students are male students and 100 students are female students. 25% of the male students and 20% of the female students are engineering students. Again, 20% of the male engineering students and 25% of the female engineering students passed the final exam. What percentage of the engineering students passed the exam? How many males are there, male students? They are 120. How many female students are there? 100. As per question, 25% of the male students are engineering students. So male engineering students would be 25%. That means 120 into 25%, and it would be 30. That means 30 male students are engineering students. What about female engineering students? 20% of the female students are engineering students. That means 100 is to 20 is to 100. That means 20 girls are engineers. Now, again, another condition. 20% of the male engineering students pass the final exam. 20% of the male engineering students pass the exam. Male students, male engineering students who pass the exam are 20%, isn't it? Yes. That means 6 male engineering students are there who have cleared the exam. And in case of female, the ratio is 25% of what? Female engineering students. That means 5. We have to calculate the percentage of the engineering students who passed the exam. How many students have passed the exam? 6 plus 5, 11. Who are engineers and who have passed the exam as well. Okay. And how many total students are there? 120 plus 100, 220. 5%. Here is your answer. Moving to the next question. A train traveling at 72 km per hour crosses a platform in 30 seconds. And a man standing on the platform in 18 seconds. What is the length of the platform in meters? 240 meters, 600 meters, 420 meters or 360 meters? First of all, we have given this one in 72 km per hour, speed of train. It is 72 km per hour. Convert this into meter per second. That is 20 meter per second. Okay. Now in first case, the train is crossing the platform. Let the length of train to be T and of platform to be P. Okay. Now in first case, he is crossing the platform. That means he is covering both the distances, that means train plus platform with the speed of 20 meter per second, we have train is taking 30 seconds. In another case, he is crossing that man only, that means he is covering its distance only with the same speed, but this time 18 distance. Okay, what is T then? 18 into 20, that means 360 meter. But this is what? This is the length of the train. We have not been asked for that. We have been asked for platform. Substitute this value over here. 360 plus P over 20, 30. 360 plus P equals to 600. P would be 600 minus 360. That is 240 meters. This is the length of our platform, option number A. Moving to the next question. In an election between two candidates, one got 55% of the total valid votes and 20% of the votes were invalid. If the total number of votes was 7500 and the number of the valid votes that the other candidate got was 2900, 3000, 2700 and 3100. Total votes which are given to us are 7500. How many valid votes are there? Valid total votes? Because 20% are invalid, that means 80% are valid ones. That means 6000 are the valid votes. among which the votes are divided between these two candidates. And the first candidate who won the election got 55% of these total votes. The first candidate got how many votes? 55% of the total valid votes. It would be 3300 votes. But this is not the answer. We have been asked for another candidate. So what will the second candidate got? It would be 6000 minus 3300. 2700 votes are gained by that other candidate. Option number C. That's all. Thank you so much, everyone. Stay tuned with us.